Kurt Kelly for Actors Reporter at Live Video Inc. 2013 AFM convention. I'm kind of staring at you because I'm trying to remember how long ago it was last time I saw.
The infamous New York Times handshake.
That handshake has been everywhere. Here, let's do it. Quick, take a picture. It was a screening of your first film.
Yeah, it was the theatrical opening. So we had done like the festival circuit for the year, and then we got picked up for limited theatrical release. We did like the Lamley Theaters.
That was Lauren Cass?
Lauren Cass.
But that was your first film also?
Yeah, it was my
first. I was there for her first film. And now you're working with Nick on what? And hello, Nick.
Hey, Kurt. How's it going? Thanks for having us on.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're...
You're not from Cleveland, are you?
No, I'm actually not from Cleveland.
Oh, yeah.
We're from Newcastle, England.
I was almost close to
that. Yeah, we just finished shooting a film in the summer. It's a fantasy film.
The two of us.
We met on the phone. That's right. Malcolm McDowell from Clockwork Orange and Ernie Hudson from Ghostbusters.
Really?
And, it's like two parallel worlds and how they coexist. And Kayla actually is she played the lead. So it was a great experience to work with Malcolm and Ernie on that film. Now we're in post and getting ready for the next one.
And who's distributing this?
That's what we're here at AFM.
We're here to.
Okay, go up and see. And you're working on another project together?
Mm-hmm.
You guys couldn't do enough on the first one?
Well, now we're producing partners.
Nice.
So it was the relationship kind of started on the film, and now it's progressive.
So what's the next film about?
It's called Zero Day. It's a political thriller action.
Right.
It's based on actual events. It's about like the first ever computer virus that was used to infiltrate into like our foreign enemies, such as Iran.
No, we did that?
Absolutely. Based on actual events. And then there's a narrative story that's fictional based around that.
So this actually wasn't served by MI6?
That's a question for you.
No, it was MI5. What's the difference between MI5 and MI6? I just became aware there's a 5.
Well, 5's very tough.
The 6 is what we let people know about the Bond films.
That's right.
The other one you have to find them out.
Yeah, that's under the rug.
Yes,
that's
right. So, how's it been working together for the first time and continuing this relationship?
It's been pretty good. I feel like whatever I don't possess, he does. So it's really, like a really symbiotic, great kind of business relationship in that perspective. But you know, he brings in a lot of like talent relationships, and then I have a little bit more of like the funding structure, and so together.
And just being able to pool all our resources just to get this film made. We're actually doing a full film slate. Starting in 2014, and we're looking at doing 4 pictures in 2 years.
And what budget were you
Between 1 and 3 for each film. So we're looking at a slate financing of 15 mil, and that way we can get cooking and do 4 pictures within that time, rather than it taking us 4 years to do, we'll be able to do 4 exciting projects in 2 years. So that's what
you already have the 4 projects locked down?
Well, we've optioned 1 script. We've got 3 on the bubble, and that's what we're trying to solidify. So
3 on the bubble, does that mean?
That we're considering. We're more or less going to have like a pool of anywhere from 3 to 10 projects that the investors can kind of like have a hand in and help choosing in that process of what is going to be slated. But 1's option, and in the process of being packaged, we Malcolm McDowell attached in writing for that one as well. And we're in talks with several A, B list talents and just kind of parlay that, so it's that much more lucrative for the industry.
Now, are these films going to be more domestic appeal or international appeal or both?
I think to be candid and honest, like with that budget range, foreign is pretty much where you get your bread and butter. Of course, we would love to have those little stories where you hear about like the micro-budget films that do so well domestically and get a wide theatrical release, but in all reality, the way that we pitch it to the investors is that they'll recoup their investment alone off of foreign plus a little bit, and then from there, domestic can just be icing on the cake. I mean, out of 4, it is definitely, we're assuming that 1 will hit to that degree, but from an investing standpoint, we're trying to at least hedge your bets, so they'll at least definitely get their money back from foreign.
So, with the films that you've done and are working on, what have been some of the
Just working with Malcolm was one of the highlights of the summer.
How so?
He's just a character, and he's got such great energy on the set, and he's such a professional. He's been doing this a very long time, and it just shows you that, the fun element is always there, and that's where the best work shines.
Any thoughts for you?
It was a great year. I brought in the financing for a $2 million project, and like Slay the Dragon as the lead, and got this guy, our production company is kicking. I feel very blessed. By definition, I have such a long ways to go, so it's very humbling to be here in the presence of like all the level A major studios and whatnot. But just as long as you keep going and tenacity, I think that's like the key.
So how many times have you both individually and collectively disagreed with yourself together at AFM and fired this event at AFM before?
When we had Lauren Cass prior to us getting the limited theatrical, I came for a one day to meet and greet through our sales agent. And then last year I came back just to like rub elbows. But I wasn't like actually here in the capacity that I am this time. So it feels different.
Yeah, do you?
And it's my first time here.
Oh, you're kind of like a reward you.
Yeah.
How's it feel?
It's great. It's I'm really excited. I came in to, doing film from wakeboarding.
Pro Wakeboarder X Games.
So wakeboarding is how I got into filming. I feel like I'm in a great, an exciting position, and things are happening, and I feel very, very lucky. It's exciting stuff.
So for someone who's never been here before, first time,
yes.
How does it compare from what you here to what is going on?
To be honest, it's
no lie to us.
No lie to us. To be honest, it's very structured, as opposed to when you go to Sundance or other things like that. But to be honest, I'm enjoying it. I've been here 2 days, but I like the structure of it, and I'm learning a hell of a lot. So it's a great opportunity.
Okay, and for you who has done this more than once in the park, what's your book?
I just think it's great to have a forum like this where you can bring all the elements together. Especially, you can get a sales agent to vet the best domestic relationships,
right.
But as far as foreign distributors, to have everybody all under one roof, and you can go out to the events in the evenings and meet and greet in that respect, and then you can also try to track them down. They're the ones wandering around.
Absolutely.
But yeah, I just think it's such a great thing that they offer to independent producers.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Kat. It is so good to see you again. I'm so glad to see you so well.
Oh, it's great to meet you.
Thanks for having us.
Right. I'm Gert Kelly for Extras Reporting.